Yeah, you can tell this is like in the gangster times. Yeah, like that kind of era. Look, they dumped the body.
Oh, they just dumped it then.
Look, it's a homeless vagrant.
Look at this guy.
He's got a bottle of whiskey.
Maybe he uses that to keep warm, right?
Yeah, maybe. I love the music, it makes it sound like it was made in that time. Yep. Even though it was like 30 years later. This came out in the 60s. And all that stuff happened like in the 30s. In the late 20s.
Food?
And he's digging through the garbage.
Yeah.
Like a scavenger. He's looking for food that has rotting flesh on it. Like a carrion.
Found the body.
Yeah.
With the shoes.
The shoes.
Maybe that's what he's gonna try and take the shoes off, huh?
Maybe. Look, he's got the same hat as Indiana Jones. Like when he was flying on the airplane. He's like looking for his wallet. His shoes.
Lovely shoes.
Those were nice for back then, though.
Oh, I know what's gonna happen. As soon as he puts on those shoes, he's gonna. It's like the soul of the dead guy's gonna take over him or something. Or they're gonna mistake him for. He's probably a wanted criminal. And they're gonna. The cops are gonna look for him.
Edward Bledsoe. A man once a specter now. One of those myriad modern-day ghosts that haunt the weeky nights of the city in search of a flop, a handout, a glass of forgetfulness. Nate doesn't know it, but his search is about to end. Because those shiny new shoes are going to carry him right into the capital of the Twilight Zone.
Oh, I love that. I love when Rod Serling says all that stuff at the start of the show.